Hello and welcome to the Google Plus Developers Live. My name is Gus Klass. I'm a developer advocate on Google Plus. And with me here today is Cartland.
Hi, my name is Chris Cartland and I'm a developer programs engineer.
And also joining us via Hangout is a special guest, Evan from TuneIn.
Evan Owski, I am a software engineer for TuneIn.
So today we're very excited to talk about over-the-air installs. And this is a really exciting feature because for users, it lets you install with one click right after you sign up for a website. And for developers, it essentially lets you get free Android installs because users are immediately converted after sign up. So it's most clearly demonstrated when you see it in action. So Cartland's going to show it to you today, and we'll talk about how to implement it.
Excellent. So I'm over here on TuneIn.com. And as a user who's signed into Google, I want to sign up with this website. And when I go to sign up, you'll see that they have a couple options. And the top one here is sign in with Google. I trust Google to handle my identity. And I want to use this website. So I am going to choose sign in with Google. I get the normal dialog that we talked about in last week's GDL. And the important thing is that when I click accept, I'm going to be signed into the app, but I'm also going to be prompted to see a dialog that says, would you also like to install the Android app on your phone? And this is really cool because I didn't even know there was an app, and I can already install it with just one click. So I'm done. As a user, this is great, as Gus said, because I can get an app without searching through a phone. I don't have to find it in the Play Store. It's already on my app. Or on my device right now. I can see the icon, and I can start using TuneIn in both platforms without any effort.
So again, you just signed up for the website, and then at the conclusion of sign up, you're asked which device you'd like to push that app to, and then boom, it's right there.
That's it. It's really easy. Now, Evan, did you have a similar experience when you first saw that we had over-the-air installs? Did you think that was a cool idea?
Yeah, I think OTA install was probably the easiest feature to get to work. Pretty much we dropped a data attribute on our sign-in button, and it just worked.
Awesome.
Spent about a minute implementing it and 30 minutes testing it. So
awesome.
Fantastic.
That's really cool. Speaking of the implementation, I can show through all those steps right now. It's going to be really fast, and we're going to see how easy it is to get over-the-air installs to work.
No, Chris, you did that so fast earlier. I bet our viewers didn't even get to see the app on the Nexus 10. So can we show that one more time just to show people where that is and maybe kind of walk that through a little slower?
Oh, sure. So on our Nexus 10 right here, the app icon has already appeared on the desktop. So this is literally the first time I've touched the device after I clicked sign in on the web. And the TuneIn app is already available. I can start looking at the different radio stations and do everything else that I would with the app. And I didn't even have to, I skipped all of the steps that were in the Play Store, and everything that I wanted was already here.
Yeah, it happens so fast and transparently that it's really difficult to see it happen because you sign up, you click install with a device you've selected, and then it's on that device.
Excellent. So again, similarly, we're going to show how fast it is to get this to actually work. So on my computer, I'm looking at the APIs console, which is where you do all of your regular configuration for Google APIs. What you're going to do is make sure that you create a client ID for Android using the same project that your web application is using. So we just choose installed application and fill out two fields. One of them is your Android app package name, which just identifies, of course, what your application is, the one that you want to install. And then the second thing you need to fill out is the SHA-1, which all you Android developers know you can use the key store to come up with the SHA-1. And then you say create client ID. And then that's the one that you will use on. And then your configuration is done in the on the web.
So again, so this configuration here, the screen that you're showing, is just these are the settings that are pulled from Android for your app. Mm-hmm. And then the next thing you're going to show is going to be
how to actually make the button do the over-the-air install.
Okay, awesome.
Great. So once your Android device is set up, like we've just shown, on the web, all we have to add is one field, and that's the app package name. So if you're using the sign-in button markup, there's this field called data app package name, it says, you know, com, Google, Android, Gmail, Sample Plus, or whatever TuneIn's app would be. And that's it. Once you put that on your page, as Evan said, that took about a minute. What else would you like to add about that, Evan?
Yeah, great. Actually, let's hear a little bit more about TuneIn's integration with Google Plus.
Sure. Yeah, first let me introduce the company. So TuneIn is the world's radio. We have 40 million monthly active listeners. You can listen to 70,000 live stations from all over the world and 2 million pieces of on-demand content. So you should definitely check us out at TuneIn.com. And while you're at it, hey, sign in with Google and grab our Android app. So yeah, let me sort of go over some of the ins and outs of what we did for our integration. So I did the web integration, and our my colleague Cliff did the Android. But so I'll focus on web. It was about I would say a two and a half week process to get everything going. So we did sign in and sign up integration. We did share. We did moments, so you can actually, if you're signed into your Google account, it broadcasts these moments. So Evan Owsky is listening to Laid Back Radio right now. And it's kind of a cool way of you know, letting your friends know what you're up to listening to on TuneIn.
Cool. So you guys are taking advantage of the app activity functionality, and so then as someone listens to radio, it kind of continuously writes the things that they're doing.
Right. So if they tune into a new station, if they tune into a new program, if they favorite something, mm-hmm. That all gets posted in their moment stream.
Yeah, awesome. And
of course, if they don't want that, they can always disable it.
Right, and one of the things that Google Plus sign-in allows you to do is give the user control over who can actually see those app activities.
Right.
So they're not necessarily broadcast to people that they don't want. They are only given to exactly who the user says should see them. Yeah, cool.
Right.
Excellent.
Awesome. So, sorry, I we totally interrupted you. Did you have, were you guys doing some work also with the interactive posts? Because they also kind of go hand in hand with those sorts of things, like, I'm listening to this now. Come and listen to what I'm listening to.
Yeah, we did implement interactive posts as well. And that was maybe second to like OTA install, the probably the easiest feature to implement. Cool. We pretty much, We had some existing metadata on our station and program pages, Google was able to pull that information down and interpret it correctly. We really didn't have to do any additional work to take advantage of that metadata. So that when you click the share button, share on Google Plus, you know, you had all the correct you know, title and description of the page. And icon as well.
That's awesome. So you you're able to, you know, pre-populate, set all the things that you want to appear in that interactive post, and then the users can selectively render it to their stream. That's cool.
Mm-hmm.
So what do you think was one of the most exciting things that has happened as a result of Google Plus sign-in for you guys? Do you look forward to getting deeper deeper functionality from this, and additional things that you have that, you know, like couldn't make it in for the launch?
Yeah, there were a few features that we were definitely thinking about including. One of the features that we ended up implementing on web was the calendar integration, which is awesome because TuneIn has a ton of live content, and we have schedules for a lot of our stations, and so you can, if you want to listen to you know, say Morning Edition, or even a sporting event. We've got March Madness coming up, and you want to set a reminder to yourself to listen to it. You can just add that to your calendar right from our Android app. That's something we don't yet have on web.
That's cool.
But yeah, we're very, very excited about sign on because it removes almost everyone who comes to our site, a lot of our users are going to be signed in already with Google. And, you know, we like to get them to sign up so that they can get some of our better features like favorites. Mm-hmm. And it just removes that extra step of having to type in email. And I know when I go to a new site, I'm pretty lazy and I don't like to have to type in a lot of stuff to sign up for an account. So it just makes it that much easier.
Yep. And additionally, I mean, like on mobile, there's nothing worse than trying to enter your password with those little keys, right?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Totally.
Yeah, so what did you think about Google's position to help your integration? What do you think anything we had was particularly special that made it great for your application?
So you know, we were part of the launch, and so we worked pretty closely with the Google Plus team, and they were great, very responsive to our questions. I think at the beginning there was a little bit of a scarcity of some of the documentation was a bit scattered, but as we saw sort of as the process went along, the documentation got a lot better, it got more filled in. And so I think some of the difficulties that we might have had early on when you know, other companies come in, when other projects come in and they do this kind of integration, I think it's going to be a lot smoother for them. Mm-hmm. And they'll be able to just jump right in, use the documentation, it'll be pretty much out of the box.
Yeah, awesome. Yeah, and do you have any advice for people who are kind of just for third-party developers who aren't kind of like you guys who had to get, you know, you got early access to it and a little bit more hand-holding? Any kind of tricks or recommendations, ways that guys are kind of starting out with this can save some time?
I would say definitely grab the sample app. The sample app was really helpful. And a lot of the examples you can just drop pretty much, you know, copy paste verbatim.
Yeah.
And they you know, just work.
So did you guys start with the quick start, or did you start with Photo Hunt?
So what was the second one?
There's Photo Hunt, which is kind of a showcase app that shows an actual full integration with over-the-air installs, and it's got Android and iOS app and also a web server. If you guys didn't start with that one.
Oh, I don't think we even knew about Photo Hunt.
Oh, awesome. That is the new then. Yeah, but you found the quick start samples to be real helpful, and mm-hmm. and they're available for all the languages that most developers use, which is handy. Cool. Trying to think what else.
Yeah, does it have any questions from people online that we can get to?
Sure. The first question that we're seeing is, some people have expressed concerns that over-the-air installs are hardware dependent. And Carlin, do you want to take this one?
Yeah, so the over-the-air installs will work on any phone with Android, what's the number, 2.3 or higher. It's Gingerbread. So as long as you have that and you have the the Play Store installed, then it'll work, which is a lot of devices.
Yeah. So yeah, there's a whole lot of Android devices out there, and the hardware dependence is just kind of, there's a minimum version of Android. So long as your device supports that minimum version, then you are good to go for these over-the-air installs. Another question is, does anyone know if the auth token from the sign-in service can be used for any other OAuth2 methods, Google services, for instance, spreadsheets? And actually, Evan can speak to this because they did calendar integration in addition to Google Plus sign-in integration. Do you want to talk a little bit about kind of the extra legwork that you guys had to do to get to enable that functionality?
So I can't speak to calendar integration too much because we didn't do that on web, mm-hmm. and Cliff would be a better person to answer that question for mobile since he did that side of it.
Yeah, sure. I can actually jump in here and talk to this. So there's only two things that you have to do. You need to turn on the services for the additional functionality that you need, and then the next thing you need to do is just request the right scopes. When the user clicks the sign in button, they'll be shown all of the scopes that you're requesting, and they can control which of them they will allow access to. So another question is, no more questions. No. So we actually don't have anything new to announce this week. But we do want to say that it's really exciting to be back onto Google Developers Live, and we look forward a lot to additional shows talking about the Google Plus platform.
Yep. And thank you so much to TuneIn and Evan for joining us today. We had a really great time talking with you.
Yeah, it's great to be here.
Yep. Well, thanks for watching.